Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. I'm coming back to you with a brand new episode of Disneyland Paris updates. I got a lot of positive feedback on the last video, so I decided let's make a second episode. Disneyland Paris has been on a roll, announcing new things, releasing programs, for example for the Halloween soiree. So just like in the last video, I'm gonna talk you through everything that's been going on in Disneyland Paris. So let's start with new updates on the current Halloween season that will go on up until November the 4th, so the end of next week. Over the past 2 weeks, Disneyland Paris has released a new Halloween snack. It is a Nutella-filled cookie with Mickey ears in the shape of a pumpkin. I haven't had the chance to try it myself, but I'm sure planning on picking it up next week and giving it a try. It looks like your classic cookie, but since it's filled with Nutella, we need to try it, right? The biggest highlight for Halloween season every year is the Halloween soiree. And this week, Disneyland Paris has released the program for the night. And I must say, I am very excited. It's one of the highlights of every year, so let me talk you through this year's program. The Halloween soiree every year is filled up with character meet and greets, parades, shows, and dance parties. And this year isn't any different. So let me talk you through all the entertainment that will be going on the Halloween soiree. So over on Main Street USA, you can meet Bon Bon Goofy, so Goofy in his candy machine outfit, the same as during the day. You can meet Marie or her friends. You can meet Stitch, or you can meet Chip and Dale. Over in Discoveryland, you can meet Darth Vader near Starport and Chewbacca near Discoveryland Theater. Over in Fantasyland, you can meet the Disney villains who are taking over Meet Mickey this year. You can meet Maleficent in the castle courtyard. You can meet the Cheshire Cat near the Storybook Land ride. You can meet the Evil Queen in Princess Pavilion. I hope it's gonna be like last year, where you could either meet the Evil Queen or the Old Hag. We haven't seen the Old Hag all year, and I miss her because she's fabulous. Then over in Adventureland, you can meet Jafar. And last but not least, in Frontierland, you can meet Mickey and Minnie or their friends near Cowboy Cookout. Most likely they will be in either their Dia de los Muertos outfit or in a special Halloween one. We will have to see. And of course, you can meet the Pumpkinkin himself, Jack Skellington, on his new photo location near Phantom Manor. Like every year, the Disney villains are taking over Mickey's Halloween celebration, and it's a parade you don't want to miss. It's a great opportunity to see all your favorite villains on parade, and they're gonna do the parade their way. You can see the parade going down the normal parade route at 8:30 and 10 p.m. For the dance parties this year, Goofy's Skeletoon Street Party is hitting Frontierland near Cowboy Cookout from 9:30 till 12:30, where you can dance, shiver and laugh with Max and Goofy and their new friends. I wonder who that will be. Over in Discoveryland, you can join Evil Emperor Zurg's disco party, where DJ Buzz Lightyear will be mixing some wild music. It will be going on in Discoveryland from 8:30 till midnight. Additionally, and very special this year, DJ Don Diablo is getting ready to hype up this year's party. This world-famous DJ will be hitting the decks in Discoveryland from midnight till 2 a.m. There will be two shows during the Halloween soiree this year. The first one is called Rock On with the Disney Villain. it's a very special one. It's a very special edition of the It's Good to Be Bad show, where you can experience the rock concert of your life. It's going to be a thrilling night. To make your way to Royal Castle stage at 5 past 9, 20 to 10, 20 to 11, 11:30, 20 past midnight and 1:10. And completely new this year is the Big Hero 6 show called Yokai's Revenge. This new show will be filled with fighting and unique laser technology with Big Hero 6 characters and Baymax. It will be performed in Videopolis Theatre at 9 p.m., 20 to 10, 20 to 11, 11:30, 20 past midnight and 10 past 1. Another two new animations this year are the Spooky Encounters Ashore. This is the official name for the new pirate walkthrough over in Adventureland near Adventureland Isle. Look out for dead pirates, zombies and creepy creatures while you pass through this creepy walkthrough between 8:30 and 2 a.m. And last but not least, for this Halloween soiree, it's Disney Channel's Wicked Sing-Along with the Disney Descendants. It will be performed in the Discoveryland Theatre over in Discoveryland at 11:30 and 12:30. Come and join in the sing-along based on the hit movies from Disney's The Descendants. I must say, even if the character meet and greet program for this year is rather a little bit disappointing, I must say they really went all out with the special animations and shows, so I can't wait to experience everything that will be going on. I need to start planning and make a schedule about these hours because, oh my god, there's really so much to do and I really want to meet Edgar and have a little word with him, but because it's not nice to try and ship kittens off to Timbuktu. Again, Disneyland Paris is promoting you sharing your Halloween costume, your Halloween look, and just everything you're experiencing on the night on social media using the hashtag DisneyHalloweenParty. So be sure, if you're attending or if you're just having a Disney-themed Halloween party at home, use the hashtag DisneyHalloweenParty. Also very special this year, and really an exception in the history of Disneyland Paris, there is some construction work going on the RER. So if you think you might have trouble getting back to your hotel, you can now pre-book the magical shuttle to Paris, which will leave from the park at between 2:15 and 2:30. It costs 15 euros per person, but if you want to avoid panic and struggle because of the construction on the local trains, make sure you look into booking this special magical shuttle. Disneyland Paris, of course, encourages you wearing your favorite costume, but there are some rules. Please, face paint is allowed as long as it's not too spooky, but do note that face covering masks and fake weapons are not allowed in the park on the Halloween soiree. Also, make sure your costume doesn't drag on the floor. This might seem a little bit silly, but they are rather strict on this rule. This being said, I think this is it for this year's Halloween season. Make sure you stay tuned for my vlog on the Halloween soiree, where I will try to show you everything that will be going on. I will try to go and see every show. I'm not gonna meet every character because they're basically the same ones as during the day, but I will try and get you some footage on every show that is exclusive and every animation that is exclusive to the Halloween soiree. Now, moving on to other Disneyland Paris news. Disneyland Paris' official website is getting a new design and new features. It has been enrolled starting from the US website and it will be continued to be rolled out on all international websites. So make sure you keep an eye open and see the new Disneyland Paris website. moving on from Halloween and straight into Mickey's Biggest Mouse Party for his 90th birthday, Disneyland Paris has teamed up with La Maison Pierre Hermé, a famous French pâtissier, and they've created a brand new dessert to celebrate Mickey's 90th birthday. The new dessert is called Mickey's Zest Party, and it is a special version of a lemon meringue tart. You will be able to enjoy this brand new dessert from November the 17th up until January the 6th, only at Walt's, an American restaurant on Main Street, and in California Grill, which is a fancy restaurant in the Disneyland Hotel. Oh wait, there is more Halloween news. If you are not able to attend the Halloween soiree party in the Disneyland park, Disney Village is stepping up their game and releasing a Halloween festivities program. So if you can't make it into the park or you haven't bought a ticket to attend the Halloween soiree, you can enjoy special animations all throughout Disney Village for free. As mentioned in the previous video, Disneyland Paris has launched a new system for Fastpass. Please do note again that this Fastpass system does not replace the free Fastpass system that will stay available all throughout the indicated attractions on your park program. But if you have a little bit more money to spend and you want to do your favorite attractions just that little bit faster, Disneyland Paris has launched this new Fastpass system. In general, there are two categories of new fast passes. First, there is the super fast pass, where you can have faster access to three attractions. This super fast pass is available both for family attractions and big thrill attractions and will cost £26 during low season and £40 during high season. Next tier Fastpass is the Ultimate Fastpass, where you can have a one-time access to all Fastpass attractions. This Ultimate Fastpass will cost £53 in low season and £79 in high season. And if you're a real thrill seeker, you can go for the Unlimited Speedy Access Ultimate Fastpass, where you have unlimited access to all the Fastpass attractions. But all magic comes at a price, dearie, but you will still have to queue a little bit as the Fastpass line is still a line, so it is not guaranteed immediate access into the attraction. Here you can see a little schedule that Disneyland Paris has made to indicate when these Fastpasses are available and whether the day you're visiting is considered low season or high season. So feel free to screenshot it if you think of making use out of the new Fastpass system. Staying inside the park, Disneyland Paris has announced that there's a new character dining on the way, and I'm so excited because meeting characters is my fave and food is my fave. So meeting characters while you're having food is just perfect. In the late 90s and early 2000s, Disneyland Paris had a lot more options for character dining than they have right now. For example, you could have tea time in Hakuna Matata, you could have pizza with Buzz and Woody in Pizza Planet, there was a tea time in Cowboy Cookout with all different kinds of characters, but along the years, these all got cancelled, reopening Colonel Hattie's Pizza Outpost after the reform as a character dining. Yes! I'm excited. I can't wait to try it. We will have to see which characters are gonna be there, but I'm sure it's gonna be very adventurous. Moving on to the Disneyland hotels, they have gotten a little update as well. Every hotel got new names for their hotel rooms. I will insert a picture right here with the old names and the new names, so you can keep this to hand when you try to book a room at Disneyland Paris. So as we all know, there is always a little gap between the spooky Halloween season at Disneyland Paris and the magical Christmas season. Disneyland Paris is bringing back Disney's magical bonfire again, this year going on at Lake Disney on November the 7th, the 9th and the 12th. Every time at 8:30 you can enjoy magical fireworks around the lake. Moving on to annual pass news and updates, Disneyland Paris has updated their perks and conditions for their annual passes. First thing, they announced that there will be no price increase over winter for the annual passes, which is great. Something that is getting a price increase is the tickets you can buy for your friends. So the tickets you can buy for one day in the two parks for your, if you're bringing friends over and you have an AP, these prices for these tickets will increase. For Magic Plus holders, the prices for your friends will increase to 45 euros and for Infinity Pass holders to 39 euros, which is literally nothing compared to the price at the till that has been raised to 104 euros per person. Also getting an update is the pool advantages that come with your Infinity Pass. But let me talk you through the fact that they will have increased availability for visiting a swimming pool in a Disneyland hotel. So per slot there will be more people allowed and the slot is extended in duration. You can now go and have a swim in a Disneyland hotel between 8 a.m. and 2 p.m. During the Sequoia Lodge refurb of the swimming pool, they will add Davy Crockett's Ranch swimming pool to its availability, and an Infinity Pass holder can bring one friend to go swimming in a Disneyland hotel. Over Star Wars season and Christmas season, there will be a VIP zone for Infinity Pass holders in the Walt Disney Studios for Goofy's Incredible Christmas and for Star Wars A Galactic Celebration. And great news for annual pass holders, the exclusive evenings will return in 2019. Disneyland Paris will look into the feedback that we all have sent throughout the surveys that have been sent after previous events, and they will update us with theming and take into account all the feedback we have sent over. So it's very important, if you attend a special evening, to fill in the survey you get from Disneyland Paris after, because they do try to listen to us. To finish off this video, we cannot not mention him. He's the star of this week's This Twitter, and it's the world famous, the powerful, the glorious Poohballoon. You might think, what's special about a Poohballoon? But this very special balloon has been stuck in the Halloween decorations for over a week now at Disneyland Paris, and he has become the star of Main Street. So if you're over at Disneyland Paris this week, make sure you snap a selfie with Pooh or you feed him some helium so he can enjoy the rest of the Halloween season up there high and dry on the gardens of Main Street USA. If you want to stay updated on Pooh's adventures on Main Street, go follow at Poohballoon on Twitter. So this was it for this video, all news and updates from the last 2 weeks at Disneyland Paris. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, hit that like button, subscribe if you want, and until then, TTFN! Ta-ta for now! In your heart there's a place, a magical space where it